We are reading from Journey Beyond Words, The Body. Greetings again. I am Yeshua. I have come this day to further with you my discussion of A Course in Miracles. I have spoken to you lately of things which do not exist. What of the world? We asked. The world is not so, I told you. I spoke to you of sin and guilt, which do not exist. Today, I would speak to you of another thing which truly, I tell you, does not exist. I would speak to you today of the body. That which you perceive so often on this earth to be what you are, it is not so. The body is not you. The body cannot be you. The body and its fate, whether it lives or dies, whether it is healthy or sick, whether it seems to bring you pleasure or pain, all of this is in no way related to what you are as the Son of God. Quote, the world I see holds nothing that I want, unquote, lesson 128. I have spoken to you of that. And especially, the world you see includes the body, which truly holds nothing that you want, because none of it has any effect on what you truly are in reality. However, there is a point beyond that, which needs to be made, and made again and made again. The world you think you see with the images within your brain. And that brain is of the body. The world you think you see with your eyes, your physical eyes, and those are of the body. The world you think you experience through your senses, be it your eyes or ears or nose or mouth or touch, and all of those are of the body. Hear me well. For this message is central to A Course in Miracles. None of that is true. Indeed, none of that exists. When you see the world through the eyes you think your body has, you see in truth nothing. But indeed, you feel that you do see the world. How can I say to you, 'tis nothing? The answer lies, as always, in your valuing. For you see that which you have accorded value. You, in your power as the Son of God, have the freedom and the ability to create whatever it is you wish to experience. Indeed, you are not a body. You can never, in truth, be a body. Over this, you have no choice. You can, however, imagine, just as you have done in order to come here in the first place, that you are a body, or at least that you have a body. It is not so. The body is a veil. The body is a shadow. The body is a false image whose purpose is to hide from you what you really are. What really are you? In a word, you are spirit. You are mind. You are an idea of God. And as an idea in the mind of God, you exist and cannot change. For God does not change his mind about what he has thought and thus created. As an idea In the mind of God, you are absolute, untouchable, unchangeable, and as an idea, you merely exist. You cannot be confined to space. Even you know, without argument, that your own ideas or thoughts cannot be contained to one point of space. You cannot be confined to time, and you even know that as well. Your own thoughts are independent of time, for in a thought, can you not move yourself to the past, or the present, or the future, merely by thinking yourself there? Indeed you can. As an idea, you are independent of time and space, and you must remain that way. Any false dreams you may have, which might seem to limit you, which would seem to make you less than an idea in the mind of God, any of these false dreams cannot be true. The primary false dream with which you live is the belief in the body. And you have believed that the body is finite in time, that it is born, lives, and dies to pass away. However, you are unchangeable. You are not born. You did not die. You do not die. And you never pass away. You simply exist. You have believed that the body changes, that it ages, that it becomes infirm, that it gradually loses strength and ability until eventually it dies. You, in reality, do not change. You do not become weak. You do not become frail. You do not pass away. You have believed that the body supplies you with your understanding of the world, with your awareness of what you are. You have believed that you must be educated, must go to school, listen to teachers, that you also must learn by experience, by trial and error, if you will. All of that is a false dream. For an idea, which you are, has complete access to and is totally part of every other idea. There is nothing in all of creation which can keep from you anything that has ever been experienced, except for your belief that you cannot find it. And that is the veil I have referred to as the body. You believe your body must take time to learn and to experience. It is not so. Your body is always nothing more than an instrument which serves you, its master, and which serves you absolutely perfectly. Your body is for you and does for you exactly what you imagine it to do. Your body cannot be born lest you, spirit, co-creator with God, elect for yourself to take imagined form and be born. And then, indeed, you seem to be born. You cannot learn anything. You cannot forget anything. You cannot comprehend or fail to comprehend any idea without that first your spirit in full awareness at its own level of truth chooses the illusion that you do or do not understand, that you can or cannot learn, and then your body, faithful servant that it is, acts out exactly what you have chosen. You cannot ever become infirmed, become weak, become frail. You truly cannot even die without first that it be your own choice. And when I say your own choice, the word your, quote unquote, your, ought to be capitalized, for it refers to your one self, your real self. Spirit, mind, the Son of God. My brothers, learn this lesson well. Let this lesson, let my words flow through your being. Time and time again, until you shall go past the words, past the thoughts within your brain, past even the emotions to experience. And when you, at the level beyond your thinking, experience what I have just said, then you will truly realize, perhaps even in an instant, that you are but an idea, a thought, and therefore are free to be anywhere and any when, in any form you choose, and your body will respond in perfect accordance with whatever you wish. Always monitor your thoughts with diligence and vigilance until you look at every experience your body seems to bring you, with the realization that this could not be, lest you, Spirit, Son of God, had first deigned that it be so, and commanded the universe to obey. If only you knew the power that you have as the Son of God. I did say, quote unquote, commanded the universe that it be so. And this is exactly what I meant. You as Spirit, you as the Son of God, you as co-creator of all that is, need only to think at the level of your real self, and that thought becomes a command to all the universe. And the universe is not forced to obey. Rather, the universe rejoices, for the universe is you in truth, is you in your oneness. It is part of you and one with you. And always, whatever your true self thinks is celebrated and honored instantly throughout all of creation. Ah, but the body, it is so frail and seems so weak, seems so beset upon by a myriad of outside influences, which at a whim can change what it would experience. The sun comes out, you feel constrained to be warm, perhaps too much so. If it snows, you feel constrained to be cold, perhaps too much so. If the wind blows, you feel constrained to sense the wind. You imagine brothers in bodies which are illusions, as grand as the illusion you have of your own. And you think their bodies can harm you, can have an effect on what your body does, where it might go. And none of it, I tell you, is so. Always your body does exactly as you bid it. In the great oneness of all creation, the wind cannot blow without it being you. The sun cannot shine without it being you. It cannot snow. Without it being you. And no brother can seem to act and influence your life lest it be you, and that brother be celebrating with you the thought which has been your command to all of creation. What of the body then? You are indeed here on this earth, albeit in your imagination. Perhaps you should kill yourself and leave this earth. 'Tis not necessary. It would be perhaps a foolish thing to do, for usually your suicides are done without full intent and awareness. Those things which you do out of pain and fear are simply that, creations of pain and fear. And indeed, you shall reap that pain and fear, for such is the power of what you are. So, indeed, you seem to be here. On this physical earth, in this physical body, all of you, what shall you do with this body? This false dream, this grand illusion, which seems to limit your days and nights and bring you frustration and pain. Two things I recommend to you. As I recommend them, always realize that you are the Son of God. You are totally free. I do not say to you, you should do this. Always I say to you, you are free. You are free to live here in the fear of the sun and the wind and the snow, in the fear of other bodies harming your own, in the fear of illness and the fear of death. You are free to live with all these fears. However, it is not necessary. Because if you would, instead, choose the peace, the joy, and the love of which I have spoken so often, what then of the body? First, as I have said this day, always remember that the body is truly nothing more than an expression of that which you have created out of your thoughts, out of your mind, out of your creative oneness as the Son of God. Now, given that you are the Son of God, not a body, but free, how then shall you walk this earth seemingly in your body? I have told you that the body, if seen and used properly, is nothing more than a means of communication. When I say, quote-unquote, properly, I do not mean there is a right and a wrong. I merely mean, if you wish to escape the misery of this earth and find peace, then, quote-unquote, properly will be thusly. The body is nothing more than a means of communication. Firstly, it communicates to you in this dream that which you have thought in the dream. You may always look at what the body seems to do, what the body seems to see, what the body seems to feel, and it will reliably tell you, it will communicate to you that which you have thought. If your body suffers pain and is ill, know that in your thinking you have imagined it to be ill. If your body suffers misfortune, know that you have imagined and desired that the misfortune befall you. If you experience peace and joy, know that you have thought and imagined peace and joy. So the body communicates to you every second what you, in that instant, have thought and desired, and have created in your imagination, constant, immediate feedback of what is going on within. So simply be aware of that. Never forgetting that what is real is what goes on within, not the external appearance. Secondly, your body, when used properly, will be a means of communication between you and your brothers. For you have made up your words and your thoughts, and always every brother knows every thought you think, and vice versa. And as you know within this dream, that your thoughts extend to every brother, that your words communicate to your brothers, that your body represents that which has been created within your own thinking, then you may communicate to your brothers in that vein. As you allow yourself to let go, I say, quote unquote, I do not know, then to say, quote unquote, I do not know, then the Holy Spirit, which shall be a still small voice within you, shall use your body for communication. Your thoughts, your actions, your words shall always communicate oneness, cooperation, and harmony. Your brother shall see a hand extended to help him, someone to walk beside him in equality and in oneness, not someone to lead or follow, but someone with whom to share equally and freely. Your brother shall see it in you, and you likewise shall see it in him. Likewise, the wind, the rain, and the sun shall sense the same oneness, and you shall feel within your being a oneness with all of this earth, with its grass and its flowers, its clouds and its sky, and all of its beauty, and you shall, in experiencing that beauty, communicate that self-same beauty to yourself and to all of your brothers, who are indeed already yourself. So know that your body is just the messenger of that which is within. As you pause and are still, the voice of God shall first echo within your being, and then grow until it speaks clearly. And that voice shall be communicated by you, without effort or struggle of any kind, to all of creation. Indeed, your body shall seem illusion. And for purposes of living on this earth, in this illusion, in this dream, that is the dream that shall set you free. Forgiveness, as it relates to your body, is the realization that it is not real. That what happens to the body has no effect on what you are. That your body does nothing more than express and communicate that which is within. When that which is within becomes the awareness of love and oneness, then you shall communicate that to all your brothers and shall experience the same in return. Then shall peace and joy and harmony follow you all the days of your life, and you shall, as a psalmist said many, many years ago, dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Blessings upon you all. That is all. And as a postscript, don't struggle to understand any of this. Don't struggle. Just full stop in the now of hearing. Quiet mind, full stop in the now of hearing, no struggle. All right, that's it.